like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves.
Being part of a hockey team, for me personally, is more the family aspect, how you've gone with all of your new friends on your team, and you spend the whole season with them, so they're like your sisters.
C'est comme faire partir d'une super grosse famille, puis si tu t'en vas jouer au hockey avec toutes tes meilleures amies, donc t'as la chance de comme jouer le sport que t'aimes avec les personnes que t'aimes, puis c'est juste le meilleur feeling.
It's like a second family for me. Every time you come to the ice, you always have your girls there, and it's like super fun. So.
What it means to me to be on a hockey team, it means that you kind of have a second family who, you know, understand what you're going through on the ice, and you can talk about things off the ice while you're in that room. You guys have so much time to bond before games and after games, and you know, everyone on there is your friend almost, and you feel a connection with everyone because you play on that ice together and you have to trust each other. So it means so much to be on a hockey team because it just means that you have people that have your back and who will be there for you, and those friendships last forever. So yeah, it means a lot to me to be on a hockey team. I miss it every day.
I think hockey teams are great for all girls and boys, so being part of any team sport, I think it brings you family and friends right away. So if you're somebody that's shy, when you're part of a team, you're automatically incorporated into a family, you automatically have friends. Every time you go to practice or games, you're automatically hanging out with people that all have to share the same passion as you.
Well, it's different for everybody, but I've only been playing for around 4.5 years after playing ringette, and it's been absolutely fantastic. I mean, my first year, I ended up winning regionals and going to Dodge Cup and repeated that the next season. It's just been incredible.
I played hockey since I was in the first grade. Hockey, greatest sport in the world. I mean, I've played a handful of sports, and you know, hockey is in my blood, it's in my heart. I mean, once you play the sport, nothing can replace it.
Playing hockey for me has been a lot of fun. I've met a ton of great people, made a boatload of new friends, and I just enjoy myself all the time.
Playing hockey for 11 years, and it's given me so many great friends, so many great experiences, and it's helped me through a lot of hard times in my life. To, it's helped me with my anxiety and a lot of that stuff.
So I play defense for Montreal Canadiens, Canadiens de Montréal. I played for 6 years there. Our league was founded 10 years ago. It started off as the Montreal Stars, and we had 5 teams in the league. So Calgary, Boston, Montreal, and 2 teams in Toronto. Over 10 years now, the league has developed quite a bit. We're still 5 teams. Now we play Calgary more often, so we used to only go to Calgary once a year. Now we go to Calgary twice a year. They come here as well, so the league has developed quite a bit. The league is a league that's owned by the CWHL, so we all share funds. So whatever funds our team brings in, we share it to all the other teams in the league. One of my favorite memories, probably when I started hockey, boys hockey, when I was 10 years old after playing ringette with girls. And I was really nervous and shy to join with boys, but all the guys on the team became probably my best friends. So every weekend after we play our morning practice at 8 a.m., we go and hang out at some guys' houses. We play mini hockey in their house all the time. During the winter, one of the guys had an ice surface, so we played hockey Saturdays and Sundays. Basically all the guys from our team got together, and it was the best introduction for me for hockey that I could ask for, to be playing with a group of guys like that.
I think my favorite memory was winning regionals in my first year, and my team got so excited that they skated at me, and I mean, I jumped into the air and then I got tackled to the floor, and they all piled on top of me and they were literally suffocating me, but the enthusiasm was there and it was fantastic.
About 12 years ago, I was coaching Pee Wee, and taught this one girl specifically how to do a wrist shot. She got a breakaway and she was skating down towards the net, and she used that wrist shot that I showed her. And then she came skating back to the bench so fast with the biggest smile on her face. And that was one of the best feelings I've ever felt in my life, and I'll never forget it.
I know when I was younger, we were always perceived as stereotypes, so we were always stereotyped as a lesbian, somebody that they only hung out with the boys, they didn't have any friends over girls, tomboys, so that's how it was when I was younger growing up. Now I think women's hockey is actually more positively perceived. I think guys think it's really cool when a girl plays hockey. There is some stereotyping still that women hockey players are lesbians, but that's a lot of times with sport in general. So if you're a woman, if you're a sport or an athlete, a high level athlete, that's sometimes go with the stereotype goes with it. But I think now people see it as that's really cool that girls play hockey and that they're just as good as the guys.
I think women are very underrated when it comes to hockey and any other sport in general. Like a lot of people are surprised when they hear that I play hockey.
I honestly think women are perceived as way weaker than men. And so I think it's good that we have our own leagues so that men aren't constantly pushing us and being like, oh, women suck, women are horrible at hockey. Because we're not. Women's hockey is amazing. And a lot of people don't realize that. So I think we deserve to be treated equally as men. And in the CWHL, the women are paid a lot less than men, and I think that's completely unfair. And I think we deserve equal pay and equal rights as men in the sport.
Well, in Canada, they're really highly appreciated, and, you know, we're just out there the way men are, and we get just as much respect. In the U.S., and I mean this talking more about the South, because I moved to South Carolina, it's really hard making it in hockey as a girl. A lot of guys, you know, when I first started playing here, a lot of guys didn't want to pass the puck to me. They had a lot of issues putting me on defense. Do they respect women that play hockey? Of course. A lot of women do have a lot of respect because it's such a difficult sport. People forget, I mean, a lot of Canadians are like, oh, skating is so easy. But you'd be surprised at how many people don't know how to skate. And, you know, with hockey is a mix of skating. There's just so much skills that go into the sport that people don't realize. So women are always respected for playing the sport. I just think that women deserve more respect in the paycheck aspect of it. And, you know, they work hard. All women that play hockey and play at a higher skill level, you know, they put it all on the ice. And, you know, you do what you love, and everyone should respect that and love what you do.
Well, if you like the sport of hockey so much, definitely go for it. Don't let anyone tell you that you're weak or that you can't do it just because of what they think. If you believe that you can excel in the sport and do well in the sport, then absolutely go for it. Push yourself, work hard, and no matter what you do, like, don't let anybody tell you otherwise. You are totally good at it, and doesn't matter what level you play, no matter what, work too in sync with it, you can definitely get through it. Be as good as you want to be.
My best advice would be have fun. It doesn't matter if you join a boys or a girls team. A lot of young girls join boys, and sometimes they have amazing experiences. Sometimes they're a little bit shy. So I know a lot of women's hockey teams are developing, and I would say 100% try it. Just being part of a team and sharing a passion with somebody, with other players, is probably the best thing you can do. It's great health-wise for you to be active. But most importantly, it's great to have friends and family and social units that you can hang out with on weekends.
Okay, so if I found out that a girl wanted to play hockey or was just about to start playing hockey, the advice I'd give her is give it 100% all the time. Every practice, go out there, have fun, and give it all you got. Same with at games, you know? Just give it 100% and never give up. And put in the extra practice hours. I promise you the outcome or what you get out of it is worth it. You don't want to be that person on the ice at the end, you know, regretting that you didn't do something at hockey that you should have done, or, you know, so put as much effort into it as you can And, you know, no pain, no gain, and I promise the progress will come out. So never give up. Keep pounding, keep working hard, and the sport, what you love to do, will just come naturally. Because if that's what you love, then you're going to do great things with it. So just never quit and give it 100% and work hard and just have fun. So yeah.
For me, in my experience, I've seen a fairly large difference in what happens inside the room. Not so much on the ice, but inside the room. There's a lot more camaraderie, there's a lot more team spirit and wanting to be there for each other than girls. Boys hockey tends to be a little bit more individual and performance based, and it's what happens on the ice. I try to treat all the same, and I try to bring a little bit of both aspects to all the teams that I coach, but that's pretty much what I see as the difference.
Share the